Alrighty guys, you've seen me from behind here. You guys know what I'm gonna do. I of course talk headphones behind here, and a lot of what I say behind here is usually about the same. And normally when I give a review, I always like to try to differentiate them as much as I can. But out of all my reviews and all the videos that I've made for this channel, I think the biggest ones that really stand the test for me are the Beats headphones. Most notably because they do strike a chord with me from my childhood, growing up in high school, and now growing into an adult. The brand is very vital to me personally. But we've also seen a lot of changes with them, and ever since Apple has secretly kind of gone their separate ways, but not entirely with Beats, Beats has been allowed to do their own thing, and they have released that with their brand new Beats Studio Buds. So in this review, we're gonna take a look at the Beats Studio Buds. We're gonna see exactly what you get when you pay $150, and we will now see the direction that Beats is heading in going in the foreseeable future. And I'll discuss more about that in a sec, but first, a word from Rogue Energy. Now the Beats Studio Buds are a very interesting pair of earbuds. They are the first earbuds released by Beats that have no affiliation with Apple in terms of hardware, in terms of chipsets, everything. And we're gonna see that very, very soon in this review. But real quickly, taking a look at the packaging, it is very, very different. It is not Apple-like how we have Apple marketing and how Apple likes to spin it. It openly acknowledges Android. It has weird different fonts, but it's trying to distinguish itself. So I'm not gonna beat it up on that. But real quickly, inside the box, you get your paperwork, your Beats stickers. You also get a USB-C to USB-C cable, which we will discuss more about. And of course, you get the headphones themselves with exchangeable ear tips. Now, normally in my reviews, I like to start with the sound quality first, but I'm gonna save that for a little bit later. Taking a look at the earbuds themselves, they are pretty good. Now, when I covered these in the rumor reports, I did have a little bit of doubt, especially being that these Beats earbuds have a very biggish design, especially with that little head. So I was a little concerned about the fit, but I gotta say, these bad boys fit very, very nice. I would argue these are very, very comfortable. They're very minimal. They are a little bulky, but they are very minimal. Taking a look at the earbuds themselves, they have a click control, so they do have a physical button, which is a positive and a negative. A positive being that you have a physical control, so you don't have to have accidental touch sensor or sensitive, but a negative because every time you have to click it, it does kind of push on the earbud. But it is not hard to push, but sometimes you can push a little too hard, and sometimes you're holding it down, whatever. That touch wheel works as the mechanism to turn on the ANC, turn on transparency, or turn it off altogether. You can also click one time for audio, click two times for play and pause, click three times to skip a track, and click four times, click one time. Okay, you guys get the order. I'm sorry if I kind of messed that up. Taking a look again at the charging case, I went with the white preferred color, and I'm actually digging the white. I really enjoy this white color. Taking a look at it itself, it feels very hollow. The plastic build on this case is not cheap. I would argue that it's a better plastic case that we've seen, but it does feel very hollow. It doesn't feel like a nice sturdy case. However, it does have a very soothing and very satisfying snap. So that is one thing to take note of. But the whole build itself is just all plastic, where some headphones have a metal hinge, this one does not. And I do question its durability, especially if you drop this, but it does seem to have held up in the time that I've used it, so I am a little bit confident going into the future. Taking a look at the bottom of these headphones, you have a USB-C, which includes fast fuel charging, where if you charge this up for 5 minutes, you can get an hour worth of playtime, and we will discuss all about that in just a second. So overall, when it comes to the build quality, it is a solid built piece of earbuds, but I am a little disappointed with the charging case. Now, if we take a look at the headphone specs themselves, these things are all over the place. So the headphones themselves can give you 5 hours of battery life if you turn the ANC on or transparency. If you use that with the charging case, you will get about 10 hours of charge total, so totaling it to 15 hours with ANC on. If you turn all that off and just use them as normal earbuds, you will get 8 hours of battery life on the buds, plus you get 16 hours with the case, totaling out to 24 hours. So that whole marketing with 24 hours was kind of a little bit iffy. So definitely take that with a grain of salt, guys. Now, let's get to the moment you've been waiting for, and you probably have skipped to this part, the sound quality. Now, this time around, this is actually the first time that I've actually recorded audio from earbuds. If you guys don't watch any of my headphone reviews, I like to get audio samples from every headphone or earbuds that I've reviewed, and these are the first time with the Beats Studio Buds, and I'm here to tell you guys that this time around, I did something a little different. I did use Pop Smoke, hashtag rest in peace Pop Smoke. I used one of his songs as the main sampler, but I decided to do something a little different. So you're gonna hear the audio from the buds, but we're gonna do it the Beats way. Because these headphones are advertised for working out and advertised for physical and intense workouts. So why don't we listen to Pop Smoke's Gangsta and let's take a trip to the gym as you hear the sound sample. I gotta say, the Beats Studio Buds are the best balanced sound that Beats has ever produced. And that's not saying much, but it's also saying something. It shows that Beats does have its deep and pronounced bass emphasis, but that the mids and the treble are nicely evened out, even your high end. Although I would argue, just like the Solo Pros, the treble does sometimes feel overpronounced, but overall, in terms of sound quality, clarity, when it comes to acoustic sound, when it comes to vocals, everything just feels nicely balanced. I truly love the sound quality on these, and I have had a blast when it comes to the sound quality on these. Now, in terms of microphone support, we are going to give you a few samples. So here are some samples of the microphone quality.
This is a microphone test on the new Beats Studio Buds. This is what they sound like if you were to make a phone call or try to talk to somebody. You will be the judge of this section of the video. Let me hear your thoughts down below. What do you think of the audio quality from the microphones on the Beats Studio Buds?
And the last thing before we end this video, let's talk about that support. Now, in terms of iOS and Android, it is backwards compatible with both. However, in my testings, I found that these earbuds work better with Android. Now, let me explain. First of all, these do not contain an Apple H1 or even a W1 chip. These are standard Bluetooth connected earbuds, but they do act like Apple earbuds by giving you better optimization in their app, but it also gives you the same when you're in Android when you download the Beats app. You do get, you know, the option in iOS, you do get a little bit of a better integration with blank Siri, but on Android, it's almost just as good. As a matter of fact, in my testing, when I reviewed these and also used these on an Android, I found that they sounded a lot louder than on an iPhone. So for example, at volume 60% on an iPhone, I was at 50% on an Android on Spotify and Apple Music, same as on iPhone. So I actually used 10% less volume on these than I would with an iOS. Now, it does ask the question, is this a firmware issue? Is this just Apple's Bluetooth codec, or what is it? Well, we don't know exactly, but I am gonna tell you guys, these headphones are definitely a lot better experience for the Android user, and I think that was deliberately chosen by Beats, which I will get to in my final thoughts. But overall, when it comes to support, you're gonna get the best from both of these with either one, but I would argue that Android is probably the way to go. So overall, what do I think of the Beats Studio Buds? Well, listen guys, it's no shocking that these are a good pair of earbuds. The positives definitely outweigh the negatives. For starters, at $150, I think that is a very reasonable price for truly wireless earbuds, and they are recently on sale for $129. So I think the price range is very, very good. The sound quality on these are tremendous. I think they have the best daily sound earbuds that I have used, at least for the daily user. They're very balanced, and it has a nice pronounced bass without oversaturating the music. I also like the fact that it works very friendly with Android and iOS. Now, there are some negatives. For starters, I think the microphone quality could be a lot better. In terms of the ANC, I actually didn't talk about it a lot, so I do apologize if you're asking where is the ANC. The reason I say that is because the ANC on these are just okay. They aren't terrible, the transparency is very nice, but it's not as loud as I would think, and you don't have a chance to kind of customize that. So they definitely don't have the best noise canceling and probably not the greatest transparency, but they work just fine. I would say they are probably better without either one of those. That's why I saved it out of this review, but you can hit me in the comments with a lot of your death threats or whatever comments you want to leave about me, and I promise you, I'm not gonna get mad. But one of my main negatives is if you're an iOS user, you're going to probably feel a little bit bummed because with the volume not being as loud for iOS users, with them switching to USB-C and really playing a lot more fairly to Android, it makes you ask the question, what direction is Beats heading in? And it looks like we've got our answer. They are heading in a better and more friendlier environment with both competitors. And because it doesn't have the H1 or W1 chip, you're not gonna get the computational audio or the spatial audio, apologies. You will get Dolby Atmos, but that's about it. And you won't be able to get it synced towards all your devices, so you're gonna have to manually pair them. So there are some setbacks with this, and there is no wireless charging, where most headphones come with wireless charging. That is kind of a bummer. I would say though, USB-C charging is faster, and it definitely charges these earbuds a lot quicker than I thought. But overall, to round up the review, the Beats Studio Buds are a great pair of wireless earbuds. They are great for everybody. If you're just an average music listener, if you're someone that likes Beats, if you like going to the gym, they're small enough to fit in your ear and they hold on for dear life. These things never fell out of my ears. that is my review of the Beats Studio Buds. And I think now that we know where Beats is headed, I want to hear your thoughts. Do you think this is the start of a brand new Beats era? Do you think we're going to see Beats in a new fashion? Let me hear your thoughts down below. If you like the video, guys, hit the like button. If you dislike the video, you can hit the dislike button. That helps circulate my views as well. As always, everyone, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next episode. Have a great rest of your day, guys. Take care, stay safe, have a good day, and peace.